What's up, everybody? Saint here for the wait. Super excited. March is Women's History Month, so we're going to talk to all of the women, every single one of them, in our line. We're going to get some amazing stories, find out about what's going on with them, what they're writing about, what they're singing about. It's going to be an amazing time. Let's get it. This is my new friend, Sophia.
Hello.
With her trench coat, which I think is amazing. Well, you're an actress.
Yes.
You're a philanthropist.
Trying to be.
Exactly. You also run a circus. Like, there's so many things you're doing in the community.
Yeah, acrobat.
Yes. Now I have an amazing woman, Chanel, with me, my new friend, and we're going to talk to her, and she's, of course, sitting in line. Nothing else better to do, so she's like, I'll talk to you guys.
$3? I feel like it was cheaper than $5 at one point.
Was it ever $3?
It may have always been $5, but I remember it being really cheap. So
maybe,
like, cool.
Because you were 18 was and you didn't know the value of money yet, seemed like $3.
That's what it was. That's what it was.
Bet.
Now I'm like 28. I'm like, nah, it's $5.
Maybe. Exactly.
It's $5. Okay.
Sometimes 10. If you catch it. Yeah, exactly. Inflation.
So my friend hit me up. She's like, you should come to this poetry thing. And I show up and it's like huge.
Right.
And I was shocked that I didn't know about it before.
Uh-huh.
Because it's been around for so long. And it's like, the line is like down there. So
right.
We said it was dope. And it's just pretty much a room of creativity.
Right. I'm a part of this women's artist group called Rebel Love. We are an activist group. We are aiming to do, create local change as well as being nationally involved in the change, but also create art that speaks to the movements that we want to see happen, the issues that we want to see addressed. Artistically, we put on shows that we feel, and films, and we film and have nights that we come together and create this material or present material that supports it. But politically, we've gotten to inform people about voting, or especially our local elections today. We did a postcard party, sending postcards to Donald Trump and immigration services and
were
education.
They like love notes to him? Like, what kind of postcards?
You know, I would not say the word love.
Not say the word love.
To describe the postcards.
Okay.
But you can write whatever you want. It's not about following our ideals. It's just about trying to make the world more proactive.
Okay.
And trying to reach out to people and get them to stand up for what they believe in.
Word.
Yeah. I've been coming on and on. I used to come when I was like 18, 19, you know, all the time, like every other week.
Right.
And then,
because you have a job.
Yeah. I was like,
Exactly.
Tuesday. Let's go.
Now you have like 3 kids and you have 2 careers. Exactly. It's harder. I get it.
I got a dog.
Okay, you got a dog.
Yeah,
okay.
I have
same
a dog.
Thing.
Same thing.
My favorite thing that Poetry Lounge has done so far was Chingona's Fire Night.
Oh, Chingona's Fire.
I was here for that. It was awesome. It was a great way to put women artists as the focal point, mm-hmm. and to have it just, I love that it was all about giving them the space to do that.
Something that like stands out to me is this girl. She was talking about Miley Cyrus.
Okay.
That's when Miley was like huge.
Right.
And she was like, twerk Miley, twerk Miley, twerk.
For those who don't know, that's Amani Cezanne.
Yeah.
Amazing poet.
Amazing. And that's the one that's like burned into my memory. Like on my deathbed, I'll say, twerk Miley.
Wow. On the deathbed, son. That's what we did.
Yeah, it stuck to me for some odd reason.
Twerk Miley on the deathbed. Just saying.
On my tombstone.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's what it's going to say. Twerk Miley, Miley, twerk. I love that. I should tell Amani that. She'll probably be very flattered.
So many people go up and like, this is my first time, I've never written a poem.
Right.
It doesn't really matter. It's your expression, your truth, and they kill it.
Yes.
And even if they don't kill it, they learn something about themselves and we learn something about our
life. Absolutely.
Come with people. And you look cool. You look like the hip person. Like, oh, I know this little poetry lounge. Let's do that on Tuesday. They come
right.
You're like, man, I'll tell you. Yeah, so you look
hip. You need a hip on game.
Yeah.
Right, exactly.
Oh, you didn't know about this?
Right.
And like, yeah, I did that like after the second.
Best kept secret in Hollywood.
Yeah, the second time I came, I was like, how you don't know about this?
Right. And you do it like you're a pro. Like, come on, get with the program. Ladies and gentlemen, my friend Chanel here, Women's History Month. This is how we get down the Poetry Lounge, the wait. Let's get it.
Get it.